Division of segments and angles, level 1. In the following series of videos, we will learn how to identify midpoints, bisectors of segments, trisection points, trisectors of segments, adjacent angles, angle bisectors, and angle trisectors. We will start this video series with midpoints and bisectors of segments. In geometry, we often work with segments that are divided in half. A point or segment, ray, line, or plane that divides a segment into two congruent segments bisects the segment. Bi is a prefix that means two, and sect means to cut. In this sense, the bisector is a thing doing the cutting. The bisection point is called the midpoint of the segment. The midpoint represents the middle of the line segment. This point is exactly halfway between both endpoints. It is important to note that only segments can have midpoints. It does not make sense to say that a ray or a line has a midpoint. Remember that segments are measurable and have a definite length. Rays and lines have an indefinite length. Recall that rays extend infinitely in one direction, and lines extend infinitely in two directions, so they have no midpoint. Midpoints are defined for segments only. For example, the midpoint of segment PQ is represented by point M. Point M is said to bisect segment PQ. This means that point M divides segment PQ into two congruent segments. We can conclude that the length of segment PM is equal to the length of segment MQ. In other words, segment PM is congruent to segment MQ. A point is not the only figure that can bisect a segment. In fact, another segment, ray, line, or plane, can also bisect a segment. For example, in the following figure, segment XY bisects segment AC at point B. We can conclude that point B is the midpoint of segment AC and that segment AB is congruent to segment BC. In this figure, point D is the midpoint of segment FE. We can conclude that segment FD is congruent to segment DE, because point D bisects segment FE. We can also conclude that ray DG bisects segment FE. In the next figure, segment OK is congruent to segment KP. We can conclude that point K is the midpoint of segment OP. We can also conclude that line JM is a bisector of segment OP, since it is collinear with the midpoint K. As a final example, in the following diagram, plane X bisects segment AB at its midpoint P. You can think of this plane as slicing segment AB at point P, creating two congruent segments, in this case, segment AP and segment PB. So a point, segment, ray, line, or plane can bisect a line segment, creating a midpoint which divides the segment in half, creating two congruent segments. Next, let's talk about trisection points and trisectors of segments. A segment divided into three congruent parts is said to be trisected. Tri is a prefix that means three. Two points or segments, rays, lines, or planes that divide a segment into three congruent segments trisect the segment. The two points where the segment is divided are called the trisection points of the segment. Recall that midpoints are associated with segments. In the same manner, trisection points is also associated with segments. This means that rays and lines do not have trisection points. In the following figure, segment AR is congruent to segment RS, which is congruent to segment SC. From this information, we can conclude that point R and point S or trisection points of segment AC. This means that segment AC is trisected by points R and S. In the next figure, if point E and point F are trisection points of segment DG, then we can conclude that segment DE is congruent to segment EF, which is congruent to segment FG. We can also conclude that segment HE and HF are trisectors of segment DG, since these figures cut segment DG into three congruent segments. All right, before we talk about angle bisectors, let's quickly talk about adjacent angles. Adjacent angles are two angles in a plane that have a common vertex and a common side, but no common interior points. For example, in the diagram shown, angle 1 and angle 2 are adjacent angles. The next diagrams illustrate examples of non-adjacent angles. Notice that angle 3 and angle 4 are not adjacent angles. When we describe adjacent angles, we are picturing diagrams like the ones on the left. Alright, now let's talk about angle bisectors. An angle, like a segment, can be bisected. A ray that divides an angle into two congruent adjacent angles bisects the angle. The dividing ray is called the bisector of the angle. In the following figure, the measurement of angle ABD is equal to the measurement of angle DBC. In other words, angle ABD is congruent to angle DBC. From this information, we can conclude that ray BD is the bisector of angle ABC. As an additional example, if angle NOP is congruent to angle POR, and ray OQ bisects angle POR, then we can conclude that ray OP is a bisector of angle NOR. We can also conclude that angle 1 is congruent to angle 2. Alright, let's end the video by going over angle trisectors. Two rays can divide an angle into three equal parts. Two rays that divide an angle into three congruent adjacent angles trisect the angle. The two dividing rays are called trisectors of the angle. In the following figure, angle ABC is congruent to angle CBD, which is congruent to angle DBE. From this information, we can conclude that ray BC and ray BD trisect angle ABE. As a final example, if ray SV and ray SX are trisectors of angle TSY, then we can conclude that angle TSV is congruent to angle VSX, which is also congruent to angle XSY. Alright, so to recap, segments and angles can be divided. The special ways to divide segments include segment bisectors and segment trisectors. Segment bisectors intersect a segment at a point called the midpoint, dividing the segment into two congruent segments. Segment trisectors intersect a segment, creating two points called trisection points, which divide the segment into three congruent segments. The special ways to divide angles include angle bisectors and angle trisectors. Angle bisectors divide an angle into two congruent adjacent angles. Angle trisectors divide an angle into three congruent adjacent angles. Alright, in our next video, we will start applying these new concepts and go over some basic examples.